by YouTube. My name's Jeff and I run a website called vegilcar.co.uk. I take used waste vegetable oil, clean it, and I run my car on it. I've had a lot of questions recently about centrifugal filtering. People get the idea that you can use a centrifuge to clean oil, but they don't quite understand the setup. So this video will basically run you through what a centrifuge is, how it works, and what a traditional setup looks like, how it's plumbed in, if you like. So what exactly is a centrifuge? Well, it's a simple device that's been around a lot longer than people realize. I believe they're actually on traction engines. That's how far back the technology goes. Basically, you take oil, you spin it around really, really fast, and out comes cleaner oil. It works on settling. Now, if you don't quite understand the idea of settling, I suggest you see my other video on understanding settling. But settling basically is that the big heavy stuff goes to the bottom and the clean light stuff comes to the top. So, using the principle of centrifugal force, if you imagine for a moment that a guy is standing with a bucket of water in his hand, if he spins that bucket of water fast enough, none of the water will come out of the bucket because it's held in place by a centrifugal force. Force is basically pushing the water up against the very extreme edges of the bucket, keeping it in place. And that's what a centrifuge does. It takes the oil, spins it round inside a cylinder, and all the heavy particles, in theory, are pushed against the very sides of the centrifuge where they stick. All the nice, clean, runny oil falls down, and that's the clean stuff that you want to use. So ideally, you end up with thick, horrible, gunky stuff stuck to the side of your centrifuge and nice, clean oil dripping out of the bottom. And that, in a nutshell, is how a centrifuge works. Oil is spun very, very fast, usually at a few thousand revolutions per minute. The centrifugal force makes the larger, denser particulates stick to the edges, which is the stuff you don't want, the fats, the water, the thick oil. And there you have nice, clean oil as a result. The mechanics of the actual setup is very, very simple. You have the outer dome, which is the dome that you see, and that hides an inner cylinder. And that cylinder is where everything takes place. Now, there's no fancy mechanisms involved. It's literally just a sealed cylinder with a couple of tiny pinholes at the bottom. And the oil is forced in at high pressure by a pump and jets out of those little holes at the bottom. As it jets out, the inner cylinder is forced to spin. So the force of the pump is translated into spinning movement of the cylinder. Around it spins, the thicker oil sticks to the sides, the clean oil has got nowhere to go but fall out of the bottom. Out it comes, usually into a large container that houses the whole setup. So let's actually have a look at the setup. What is a setup for a typical centrifuge? Well, the obvious place to begin is the centrifuge itself. This usually isn't the most expensive part of the setup, but you do want to make sure that you spend a bit of money on your centrifuge. Don't go with too cheap. If they're too cheaply manufactured, they can be off-balanced, in which case when they spin, they'll rattle like mad and they just won't work very nice. You won't get the results that you're looking for. But the heart and soul of any centrifugal filtering system is the pump. Now, the pump actually jets out the oil at high pressure. So you are looking at a sophisticated pump, if you like, not the sort of thing you'd use in your garden or what have you. This pump, it needs to produce pressures of around about 7 bars or so, is quite typical, and it needs to maintain that because it's forcing the oil through very, very narrow apertures, if you like, the little tiny pinholes. And so that force needs to be steady, it needs to be there. So the pump is the beginning of everything. You're going to need to spend quite a bit of money on your pump if you want one that's going to work for you. Next, of course, you've got the container. Now, this is usually a steel drum. And the reason people use a steel drum is because you can then bolt the centrifuge onto the side of it. If you're using a plastic drum, it's not going to work as well. So now we come to the real crux of the matter. Now, this is the bit that really used to throw me when I used to look at videos and what have you. I used to think, well, what's the setup? What's going on here? I don't understand. I can see that the centrifuge is spinning, and I can see there's a pump, and I can see oil running around, but what's going where? Where's it going in? Where's it coming out? I don't understand. Well, it's not really going anywhere. It's simply recycling all the time. I think that's probably the most important point, and it is the point that I didn't get right at the beginning. The oil isn't going anywhere. The pump is taking the oil from the container, the steel drum, if you like. It's taking it, say, from the bottom. It's cycling it up to the centrifuge, where it's cleaned and then drops back down into the same drum. So the whole thing takes place rather, in just the one container. It's going out of the steel drum and going back into the steel drum over and over and over again. So it's a cycling process. It's not a case of it passing through the centrifuge once and being clean. The oil needs to pass through the centrifuge several times because each time the oil is getting slightly cleaner, but it's never really getting fully clean. Hence, three or four passes at least is required. In many ways, it's actually a very inefficient process because, at least if you're passing the oil through a mechanical filter, it's going in dirty, coming out clean. Whereas with a centrifuge, it's going in dirty, coming out cleaner, then it goes back and dilutes the remaining dirty oil with clean oil. And so the process repeats. Clean oil into dirty oil, clean oil into dirty oil, clean oil into dirty oil. Obviously, the dirty oil that's inside the steel drum gets cleaner and cleaner and cleaner as time goes on. But it takes a while. And that's why when you listen to people talking about centrifuges, you'll hear them talk about number of passes and what have you. And that's what they mean. It's the number of times the content could potentially go through the centrifuge. Now, the other confusing thing when you see videos of a centrifuge working is that you see some of the oil coming out of the centrifuge, but then you see oil coming out of somewhere else, a pipe that leads up to the centrifuge, and you think, what's going on? Is that leaking or something? Well, why isn't it all plumbed in properly? Well, that's the point. Because it's at high pressure, the centrifuge itself has to work at a specific pressure, and this is regulated using a lever valve. Now, the lever valve just is a very simple device. It pinches, if you like, the inside diameter of the pipe, restricting the amount of oil that can go through. So you need to turn the handle of the lever valve to regulate the amount of pressure that the centrifuge is receiving. So the oil goes into the centrifuge at a specific pressure. Well, the rest of the oil that couldn't make it through has to go somewhere else, and that just gets pushed straight back into the same barrel. Now, this is all critical to the running of a centrifuge. It's all about the right pressures. Now, the pump itself is going to give out oil at a specific pressure. Now, who knows, maybe that pressure is, say, 9 bar, and your centrifuge can only receive oil at a certain pressure, otherwise it will just fall apart. Let's say 7 bar. So you've got to lose 2 bar of pressure, maybe. And that's why you have to have a pressure release system. That's why at the side of your centrifuge, you're going to have a little pressure gauge. You're going to look at that and you're going to make sure that you don't max out your centrifuge, because if you do, you're going to kill it. It's no good to you anymore. And you want pressure relief so that you don't ruin your pump by forcing it to pump nowhere. It has to have a release. If it doesn't have a release, you're going to break your pump. So it's all about that pressure relief. So if you like, the oil comes out of the bottom of your container, goes through your pump, into your pressure relief valve, i.e. your lever valve, where you regulate the pressure. Most of the oil will go through your centrifuge where it's spun, but the little bit extra, that bit that was just too much, will fall out the bottom of your pressure relief. So it's coming out of two places. It's coming out of the centrifuge and it's coming out of the pressure relief valve. So again, it's another bit of built-in inefficiency, because only the stuff going through the centrifuge is getting cleaned. The stuff that's coming out of the relief valve isn't clean at all. It's still dirty oil. So as I say, you're always getting dirty oil and clean oil mixed together. So it does take several passes, hence the term passing through a centrifuge. So let's have a look at all this in an animation to hopefully make it a little bit clearer. Now, something I haven't actually mentioned until this point is the heater. Now, to work properly, the centrifuge needs the oil to be nice and thin. And the way to get oil thin is to heat it. You need to heat it to around about 50, 60 degrees. And again, you need to look at your pump to make sure it can handle the heat. And you have to make sure that the centrifuge is up to the job as well, but normally they're not too bad with heat. But as I say, you must heat the oil to make it nice and runny. The problem there, of course, is when you heat the veg oil, you're also heating the fats, and they can pass through the centrifuge. Another built-in inefficiency. But anyway, we won't go into that one. So you heat up the oil till it's nice and warm. Then the pump kicks in. You can see the oil flowing around the system. It's going up into the centrifuge through the pressure release valve. Pressure release valve, of course, being the lever valve in this case. Notice the importance of the lever valve. As you turn the lever valve just even slightly, it affects the pressure, and you must use that lever valve to ensure that you're getting the right pressure into your centrifuge. So there we have it. The oil goes in, it spins. That's a traditional setup. That's pretty much what 90% of people use when they're cleaning oil using a centrifuge. Steel drum, pump, pressure release valve, centrifuge. That's it. Nothing really that complicated, and the whole thing just cycles round and around and around and around until it's clean. When it's been completely cleaned, then obviously they're going to use the same pump to pump the oil out into a storage barrel, or maybe they'll just keep it there as a storage barrel. But in a nutshell, that is it. I have actually got one final tip for you if you're going to use a centrifuge. Now, obviously, when you're cleaning oil, one of the main problems with used vegetable particularly is water in the oil, and that is something you really need to get out. And a centrifuge will do that, because water is heavier than oil. So whilst the centrifuge is spinning, all that water is held up against the sides of the centrifuge, and it's not falling back into your steel drum. However, the moment you turn off your pump, the pressure eases off inside the centrifuge, and all that water can then run back down into your nice clean oil, meaning that you've just ruined the whole process. So here's the tip. Just before you turn off your pump, place a small container directly underneath the centrifuge. Obviously take care, because there's hot stuff coming out of there. It doesn't need to be massive, just a small bucket. Place it under the centrifuge, turn off your pump, and then whatever's left inside that, discard. You don't want it, because there's probably oil and nasties that's coming out there, and that saves ruining all your work of all the nice clean oil that you've got there. And well, that's it really. I can't think of anything else to talk about with the centrifuge. If you've got any questions, do feel free to post them to me. I will be making more videos. I'm getting quite a lot of requests at the moment, so feel free to subscribe and check out my website, www.vegoilcar.co.uk. I'm always happy to answer questions on the subject of veg oil.